Hi, Mr. Richards here. Let's take a look today at a new concept of discount. Our objective today is to solve problems involving discount, so let's look at what discount or markdown is. Well, discount or markdown is the amount by which the regular price of an item is reduced. The sale price is the regular price minus the discount. If we look at our first example, a shirt is regularly priced for $42. It is on sale for 15% off the regular price. What is the sale price of the shirt? Well, there are two methods we can use to solve. One method is to subtract the discount from the regular price. The other method is to subtract the percent of the discount from 100%, then to multiply. So if we start with method one, subtracting the discount from the regular price, we can once again use our percent equation, which is part equals percent times our whole. Well, our part here we don't know. That's our discount, so that's going to be D. Now, our percent here is 15%. But remember, we have to move the decimal place over twice to the left to get this into a decimal 0.15. So our percent is 0.15 times our whole, which is 42. Now 0.15 times 42 is $6.3 or $6.30. So that is going to be our discount. Now, if we take our $42 and subtract the $6.30, you would end up with 0 there, 7, bring your decimal point down, borrow, $35.70. So that is your final answer. Our discounted amount was $6.30. Subtract that from the regular price of $42 and you get $35.70. Now, what if we look at a different method, but one that's also similar? Now this involves subtracting the percent of the discount, 15%, from 100%. So if we take our 100% minus our 15%, we get 85%. You know what that 85% represents? Once we multiply that by our 42, 85% of 42 is our sale price. So once again, we could use our part equals percent times whole. Our part this time we'll call S, since that's going to be the sale price directly. That's going to equal 85%, but remember, as a decimal, you have to move your decimal place back twice. So it's 0.85, so put in the 0.85. Then times the whole, which is 42. And when you multiply 0.85 times 42, you get 35.70, or once again, $35.70. So if you're looking for the discounted amount, you can use method one and then subtract, but method two may be easier if you're just looking for the sale price. The choice is yours. As we move on to a slightly more complex problem, we need to find the sale price with tax. We have a couple steps here, but a CD that has a regular price of $15.50 is on sale at a 25% discount. What is the sale price with a 6.5% or 6.5% tax? Well, there are three steps here. Step one, find the amount of the discount. In step 2, we'll subtract the discount from the regular price. And lastly, the percent of tax will be applied after the discount is taken. So let's find the amount of discount using our percent equation, where part equals percent times the whole. Our part is going to be our discounted amount, D. For our percent here, make sure we pick the discounted percent, which is the 25%. We need to get our 25% into a decimal form, which is going to be 0.25. So our percent is 0.25 times our whole, which is $15.50. When you multiply these two together, you get D equals 3.875. Now, I know we typically don't write money past the pennies point, but let's keep that until the end of our problem. Now, we want to subtract the discount from the regular price. So, our regular price was $15.50, and I'm going to need an extra zero, minus the 3.875, and go ahead and subtract, and it's going to take a little bit of borrowing. 10 minus 5 is 5, 9 minus 7 is 2, more borrowing. 14 minus 8 is 6, 4 minus 3 is 1, and 1 minus 0 is 1, so now we have 11.625. And again, try not to round until the end, all right? Try not to round until the end. Now we need to apply the percent of tax in step 3. So our tax is 6.5%, which as a decimal, move the decimal place over twice, is going to be 0.065. Now we are looking for 6.5% of the 11.625. So all we need to do now is take our 0.065 and multiply it by that 11.625 to get an answer of 0.755. So our tax is 75.5 cents. Add your 11.625 to the 0.755, and you end up with 10, 8, 13, 2, and 1. So our final answer, $12.38. Now in our next example, we want to find the original price if you know the discount and the sale price. So as we read example 3, a cell phone, well, no, not sale, but maybe cell phone, is on sale for 30% off. If the sale price is $205.50, what is the original price? Well, let's use our percent equation. Our part is going to equal our percent times our whole. Now, if it's on sale for 30% off, that means the sale price is 100 minus 30, which is 70% of the original price. Again, the logic there, it's on sale for 30%, meaning that that sale price is 70% of what the original price was. So are $205.50, that being the sale price, is actually the part in this question. That's the smaller part here. And our percent needs to be the 0.70, since 70% as a decimal is 0.70. And we can multiply that by our whole, which is, well, here it's P, because that's going to be my original price. Now, to solve this equation, divide by 0.70 on both sides, and your result is 293.571, and it keeps going. Well, if you need to round here, we're going to round to the nearest penny. The one's not going to round the seven up, so this is simply $293.57. As we go on to our last example, we need to compare in order to find the better price. Now, Clothes R Us and Ratcliffe's are having sales. At Clothes R Us, a pair of sneakers is on sale for 50% off the regular price of $50. At Ratcliffe's, the same brand of sneakers is discounted by 30% off the regular price of $40. Which store has the better sale price, and explain? Well, let's start by finding what it costs at Clothes R Us. Well, we're looking now for 50% of $50. Well, that's 0.50 times 50, which is $25. With Ratcliffe's, let's use that method too. If it's discounted by 30%, that means I can take 100 minus 30 to get 70%, which is 0.70. Because if I find 70% of $40 by taking 0.70 times 40, I will get that sale price instead of just the discounted. Taking 0.70 times 40 is going to be $28. So when I compare which is the better sale price, well, Clothes R Us wins, since $25 is less than $28. And that's it.